Hello, friends. My name is Alex Greckis, and I want to welcome you to the Finding Lost Civilization series. Today, I'm trekking in the ancestral homeland of the Native American people once known as the Salinan. We're located in South Monterey County, California. Today, we're going to visit the places where the Salinan people once lived, prepared their food, and worshipped. I tell you, this is going to be an exciting journey, and I invite you to come trek with me. Friends, I'm in a Los Padres National Forest in Monterey County, California, and I'm at a location where the ancestral home of the Salinan natives once roamed, and our quest today, our journey, is to find signs of ancient life. Well, in front of us we have what appears to be a path right here. Look at this right here. But my friends, you know, this is not a path made by modern man. Right over here is the top layer of the soil, right here. So you go down a foot right here. So this was made by feet, by traffic, but not by modern man, because modern man does not live here today. This roadway, this pathway, is a pathway created by the ancients hundreds and probably thousands of years ago. I tell you, I know we're on the right path. Well, this truly looks fascinating. Oh my goodness, look at this, right directly in front of us. Look at the ceiling. You can see this is an overhang directly in front of us. And the blackened ceiling indicates that this was created from campfires at this very location. My goodness, this is really fantastic. And so let's go further into this location. My goodness, look at this. As I said, these are fire blackened ceiling, and my goodness, it's almost as big as a cave. And oh, look at this, directly in front of us, look at this, this big sandstone boulder has all these mortars in there. Oh my goodness, this is really a joy. Look at this right here, look at this right here. So we are now in a place again inhabited by the ancients. My goodness, look at this. Okay, I'm going to try to count these mortars. I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. My goodness, friends, there's well over 30 mortars on this sandstone boulder over here. There is no doubt in my mind that this was a great, a fantastic village site many, many, many years ago. This is truly a beautiful location. It's a small little valley with a water source to our right over here. There's a stream. So water was a source of life, and this is why the ancients were here. I tell you, this is really fantastic. Look at the ceiling right over here. Right over here, and it's very dark as we go further into the center right over here. So the natives had campfires here once. They lived here, they stayed here. Right here, it's nice, cool. You're out of the rain if it's raining. You're out of the sun if the sun is bearing down on you and it's very hot. And look at the view you would have had at one time. Of course, right now we have vegetation. But perhaps many years ago, this was clear so that you could see out to the valley below you. This is very, very, very fantastic. walking along the cliff face here, and it's very precarious. One slip and I can fall 100 feet below us. But look at this beautiful area right over here. Look at this giant slab that fell apart from right here. But look at this overhang. I'll tell you, this is fantastic. There's no doubt in my mind that ancient man once habitated this spot. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a walk along this break over here. And let's see what we can discover together. This is truly fascinating. You know, this is a geologic feature that, you know, is really fascinating. Look at this. A clear break right here to our right. This large slab of sandstone broke off right over here and separated from here, the ceiling. But look at the ceiling. It's blackened. It's blackened from smoke. I'm sure we're going to find signs of ancient life. So we're going to continue our trek together. I'm walking slowly. In my right hand I have the camera. In my left hand I have a walking stick. And hopefully we can do this together without any injury. Well, there you go. Look at this over here. Right there. Right there. Do you see it? This here is a small food preparation area. Okay, so we're going to go forward. Here we go. I'll tell you, this is really exciting. What I'm going to do is turn around. And you're going to be able to see where we came from, right over there. Look at that. Truly fantastic. And this is the view in front of us. My goodness, it is beautiful. There's the dry stream bed or river. So here we go. We're going to set foot on this shelter area over here. Oh my goodness, right there in front of us, I see some mortars. So without a doubt, ancient man once habitated this shelter. Do you see it there directly in front of us? There's a small mortar there and another one there. I'm going to walk out here to the ledge, so to speak. Let's take a look here, see how it looks. Okay. It's not a straight drop in every place, okay? But right over there, directly in front of us, it is a straight drop of at least 100 feet, if probably I would say maybe even 200 feet. So I'm going to turn around. There is the shelter. My goodness, look at that. Very large, very beautiful. And look at the darkened ceiling. As I said, these are signs of ancient man. He probably had fires here to keep him warm in the daytime, or I should say at nighttime, fires to cook his food. This is really, really fascinating. One of the great things about trekking out here in nature, finding signs of ancient life, is actually seeing how nature works. Look, right here behind me, there's this fantastic tree. And you see all these holes over here? Do you see all these holes? This is made by the woodpecker. But the reason he's making these holes in here is to store food. Look at this right over here. Can you see that? This is an acorn right here that the bird has placed in there for food when times are hard. Look at this, okay. Here's a, let me pull one out. There you go. Can you see it? There, that's the acorn. So what the woodpecker will do, he'll come back here after the acorn season. This is food, and he'll come here and retrieve it. I'll tell you, you know, nature is fantastic, and finding these things is a real pleasure, and I hope you enjoy seeing this as much as I do. Well, directly before us is a dry river. You know, hundreds of years ago, this place was a lush valley. It still is in a way, but right now we're in a severe drought, probably the most severe that we've had in several hundred years. But let me lower the camera right here and let me show you something beautiful. Look at this over here. Look at this boulder containing the mortars. Well, here's what's fantastic. Some of the mortars are empty, so to speak. Look. You can see the water in them. Some of them have grass growing out of there. And this is how you can identify a mortar spot sometimes, because it looks like a tuft of grass growing outside of the stone. And that's because the mortar is filled with earth and it gives nourishment to the earth so that grass can grow out of there. So this is one way that you can identify that there's mortars, perhaps on a rock or a stone. But anyways, let's walk a little further over here. Yeah, I tell you, this is really exciting because I don't think anybody's been here for hundreds of years. And well, this is strange. Look at this over here, directly in front of us. Oh my goodness. Look at this. As I said, nobody has been here for hundreds of years. Look at this. Right out of, this is a mortar right here. You can see the grass growing out. And look at that. I'm telling you, I believe this is a pestle. All right. Let me see. Oh my goodness. It is. I can feel it. Look at the weight. Oh, look at this. I can't believe it. This is really, really amazing. This is an ancient pestle, okay? look at this. Smooth as silk right over here. Belonging. Okay, let me put it right back in. Look, it fits in perfectly to this mortar. I'll tell you, this is really, really a wonder to actually find the companion pestle to a mortar that was left here hundreds of years ago. I tell you, this is like a Christmas gift. We should all be happy to see this. It's not often that you can see this type of sight. Well, friends, I want to show you how that pestle was used. That's how it was held, right there. And you see where the thumbs are and the fingers are? It was actually designed. There's finger grooves there to hold the stone. This is really fabulous. And of course, there's the pounding end, the pestle end. That's the handheld end. Now, we're going to show you how it was used, okay? Okay, it was used in that type of action, right there. This is really fantastic. Well, it's not often that you can see this here in I guess, at the actual event, the moment it was found. This is just really incredible. Now, not all mortars were used exactly in the same fashion. This over here, all three of these, if you look at the head right here, the lip, it's conical in shape. And so what occurred here is there was a pounding and then a turning action. Pounding and turning. In some cases, you'll see mortars that are strictly vertical where only a pounding action occurs. But in this case, it was pounding, twirling, pounding, and twirling. These are very deep mortar holes right here, and they're all conical in shape. This is really beautiful. But let me show you this one mortar over here, which I really think is fantastic. Very classic. So when you're looking at mortars, at least in this area, these were used for acorn preparation. Right here is a small area. They're referred to as cupules or anvils. And so right over here is where the acorn was broken open and then placed in here and then pounded in this fashion to create a flower type substance. This is really, really fascinating. Friends, this site we're visiting is very special because it's largely unknown. And the things that we're seeing right now are things that have been hidden for hundreds of years. The last time these sites were used is when the Padres built the San Antonio Mission. Shortly thereafter, you know, all the Salinan people, or most of them, or many of them, were taken into the mission. And their cycle of life was completely changed. Their language was changed. Their history was lost. And so many of these sites are unknown. Right here in front of us is what I'll call a milling station. But in this area, we've found over 50 mortars, so it is actually a village site. Let me show you some of the things that we found over here. Look at this. Okay, these mortars right here, we cleared them so that you can see what they look like. But essentially, if you look at this one directly in front of us, for example, right over here, or right over here, this is a mortar area, or right over here, these have been covered over for hundreds of years. And so I feel a sense of joy to be able to see this part of history and to be able to share it with you. Well, friends, one of the fascinating things about trekking in the footsteps of the ancients to visit their old sites is to also find things in nature that are interesting to see. Look at this directly in front of us. We're under a very large oak tree right over here. And if you look below the oak tree right over here, you'll see a large boulder here to my right. And as you go to the left, a large boulder over there. From here, there's I can see a mortar site right at the edge of that large boulder. But this configuration directly in front of us over here is the home of a California wood rat. So what they do is they pick up these dry twigs laying on the ground and they build themselves a large nest. That nest is about 4 feet up off the ground. This animal, the California wood rat, was also a food staple for the local natives that lived in this area. So as I said, it's fascinating not only to see areas where the ancients lived, but to see their food preparation sites and actually to encounter a habitat of an animal that was also a food staple. Again, there you have it, right in front of us, the California wood rat. We're under an acorn tree right here, and right adjacent to it, look over here to the left, is a large boulder. My goodness, look at this. You can see some mortars, and again, there's the river directly ahead of us. But let's take a walk up to this large boulder over here. Look at this, my friends. I tell you, this is really fabulous. Again, signs of life. My goodness, look at this over here. Mortar right over here, and over here. But look at this, there's another one right there, and there's some stones right there. Let's take a look at those stones over here. Let's see what they are. My goodness, look at this. Oh geez. Okay, look at this over here. See this here? This could be part of a fire starting apparatus right over here. This stone, oh gosh, yes, I believe, here's how it was used, okay. You would take this stone, there would be a stick here, okay? This would be the top of the stick. In other words, right over here would be your weight. The stick would be in here, it'd be right here, and then you'd have what's called a bow drill. And so with this drill, you'd be going this way, turning the stone, the fire starter, right here with this weight on top of it. My goodness, you can tell it's been, this is not natural to the stone. This is really fabulous. So I believe this was part of what I'll call a fire starter kit. And what I'm going to do is demonstrate to you how it was used. Okay, friends, I'm going to show you how this fire starter rock worked. Okay, you see this right here? It's got a little groove over here. And as I held the stone over here trying to figure out how this fire started working, this is the thing about these stone tools. You'll always find finger holds or a hand hold. So I placed my hand right here, and these fingers right here fit there perfectly, and of course the thumb over here. So you would take this here, right here, this would be the weight to your fire stick. Let me step back and let me show you what I mean. Okay, right here would be a stick. There's the weight. You would put this over the stick. You would put the stick down onto another stick, and then with a cord or sinew, intestines, you would take it and like a bow and arrow go this way, which would be turning it like this. It would be turning it like this. The stone would create the pressure right here. As this was turning this way, it would create friction at the bottom and create fire. It would create embers. So this here is part of what I would call a fire starter kit, fire starter tool. Perfect example. This is, I'll tell you, this is truly fantastic. I mean, to find this stone tool. Now, one of the things about stone tools, you'll find finger holds because they're made for the hand to be used. Okay, right here, I can actually feel where the finger is. And on top of that, it's discolored. The oils from the hand are right here. I can actually see it. I hope you're enjoying this as much as I have.
Song, and we can groove to the rhythm all night long. Like I said before, you gotta slow it down some more and play some sweet soul music here for me. I just can't get enough.
Well, friends, I hope you've enjoyed the journey we've taken thus far. In our next segment, we're going to visit an ancient Salinan cave where shamanic practices were once held. Now, this cave today is off limits, and so our journey there will be taken vicariously. And what I mean to say is that I was fortunate enough to find some archival film taken of this cave many, many years ago. I'll tell you, this is going to be a fascinating journey.